All right. Okay. Okay. So now, first of all, there will be some briefing. If I know you guys are, I'll only put D&D. People are disturbing. Few of you know what I'm going to talk about. Louise, her philosophy, you have been attending from past few years. Few of you are totally new. So I'm taking a quick poll so that I know what kind of crowd is there. So in detail, I have to go about something, or I can just go with the next line. Okay. So just let me know, what can you see on the screen? Can you see the poll, the questions? Can you see on the thing? Just type yes or no. Just click in whatever is there. Okay, thank you so much. So this is just to know where we are. I'll give you just a minute. Okay, I'm getting these answers of the questions. Okay.
Hello. I don't know what to do.
I just click no. If you can see first question, have you read the book, You Can Heal Your Life? If yes, put yes. If no, put no. I mean, just click on the yes or no. You just click it. That's it. Then the next question. I'm sorry.
Age also, but.
So people, 44% have voted. Quickly, just 30 seconds more, quick.
I know. Where can I go?
Can you see it on the screen?
No.
It is on the screen, darling. The poll is on the screen with everyone. People are submitting. I'll give you only 20 seconds more. Okay, 10, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I'll end. Before I end, just click submit button. So if you have not submitted, it will not be read. So just click submit button. The book you're referring is by Louise. Yes, yes. Okay, so I'm ending. Now you won't be able to submit, okay? So I've got 23 people, 79% people have voted. So I'll give 10 more seconds. If you have not submitted, if it is incomplete, just click it to the submit button. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, end. Okay. Okay, so do you want to see the result, everybody? Okay, let me share with you guys. So there are 52% of people who have read the book. 48 people totally new. They haven't read the book. Okay. Any workshop attended? 48% have attended. 52 have not. So you are not really sure about this thing. Okay. So we have, do you tend to give up on your dreams? 52% people say yes. They tend to give up on their own dreams. Do you tend to criticize yourself endlessly? 22% say yes. Do you not take good care of your body? 35% ignore their body, okay? Do you accept unfulfilling relationship as part of your life? 35%, it's huge. Do you feel guilty when you live for yourself? 26%. Do you become afraid of leaving your... Wait, sorry, I have to do it. Okay. So what we can see here is a clear thing that we tend to procrastinate, we tend to give up on our dreams and all those stuff, okay? So why it was important, very important to understand this statistic so that we know where we stand. Only then we can go where we want to go, right? So let me come back to my presentation. Sharing, I'm sorry. Okay. So was it an eye opener? If yes, say yes in the chat box. It's not only you. You know, these kind of quizzes kind of help us to understand that we are not alone in our boat. I'm not the only one who's doing this. I'm not the only one who... There's a lot of noise, is it? I can't hear the noise. I'll mute it. Okay. Thank you. So there are lot many people who are living the life of others' dream, not for their own sake. There are lot many people who are procrastinating. There are lot many people who don't even know what they want and desire or deserve. There are lot many people who cannot say no if they want to. They're people pleasers, okay? And if you know my story, I was one of them. And if you know those who have said no, they know where they're coming from and what was there and now what is there. So good, let us go into the thing, what we have to discover a lot many things today. And you will shift from one level, whatever you are right now, to the next level in this workshop, okay? So be there with me till the end. All right. So this is Louise's thing. What are we going to cover? So a lot many things to be covering in this workshop. So all these things we are going to cover, learn to love ourselves, learn to get rid of negative beliefs. We need to understand how are these things coming? Why don't we take care of ourselves? Thought cycle, our limiting past experiences. We rediscover the new ways of thinking. How cool is that? Right? Cool if you feel, wow. So right? Cool if you feel it's cool. And all of them will be really, really very, very doable steps. Okay. If you're there with me, I need this interaction. I can see only 4 or 5 people. Oh, yeah, yeah. Neetu, thank you. So you can put a thumbs up or the symbol also, and that is good for me to go. Thank you. Okay. So now let us jump in to the next one. Now there'll be special offer from Louise Hay, a journey which we'll take up, but I'll discuss it about it a little later. So distractions I've already discussed with you. So if at all still your phones are not on silent or DND and all, please do it right away because we are beginning now. Okay. And it's for you. The moment you are distracted, you miss on something and it's really not a casual workshop what we have. It's a workshop, not only a webinar what we're doing. Okay. You need to be participating. You need to be doing the exercises I'll be telling you to do. Okay. Okay, so for those of you who do not know me, so a small introduction. So I'm a Helio Life coach from past 5 years. I've been into spirituality from past 30 years, I can say. And then many more things. I go from my heart. So I get called for something and I do it. I just jump in. I feel there is no limit to your growth. There is no limit to explore yourself, to make your life worth living, beautiful every moment. So these are the few things I have been doing it. And then this is important. Okay. Now it is a real important research. What we went through the polling now. Okay. Even now when I go to the poll result and again show you, it will say only 8% of the world. Okay. 8% is, imagine, only 8% of people live the life they really want to live for themselves. And that's really sad. So I don't know, in our group, I could not find anyone. Nobody said giving up. So now you need to tell me, why do we think we can't live the life of our own? You know, what is the thing which is obstructing us? So if you know the answer, put it in your book and then match with my answer. Because if I keep talking, it will be a longer time. Put it in your book. I'll give you a minute. Why do you think 92% people only compromise, only live the mediocre life? They are not living up to their own levels, you know. Why do you think? Write one or two reasons quickly. Or you can write, why do you not live your life of dream? You can connect to yourself. This is a stats for everybody. And if you can put up over here on the chat, it will be most welcome. Hi, Krupali. I just saw you. Hi. I can't see you on the screen. I saw you now. Okay. Okay. Dan, if you can and if you feel okay to share with us, fear, society, yes, Vishalini. unaware of what we want. Krupali, you're so like me. So we are not even aware what we want. And then we're like, what is it happening? I mean, you become, I will come to it. You will see. Okay, yeah, cool. So we have fears. We have fear of society. So what will he think? What will she think? What will be my name? And most of the time, especially women, I feel, I don't know, it can be sure for males. They don't even know what they want, you know. That was my condition, my mother's condition. Kripali had said hi-fi to me. Okay. So let me go ahead. And you note it down, okay? To make everyone happy, think about others before us. Yes. To make others happy. Perfect, Sanghi and Lekha. Yes. Let me go ahead now. So this was like, what is holding us? You've written, it's our fears. It's our pleasing others. Others are important. We don't give importance to our own life. Now, the major thing, okay? The major thing what we shared here is two things. Now, this part is super important. This is the heart of the whole thing what you're going to work on, okay? This is super important to pay good attention. If you do not connect, if you feel there is something wrong, please ask questions, okay? But you need to understand this. Okay. So what holds us back? There are two things. One is internal limitation. Okay. The internal limitation, somebody mentioned fear. Fear is not external. It is inside me. I'm scared of living my dreams. I do not know what's happening. Like, I'm not even sure what is it I want. So that is my internal. If you've written, you will segregate. Is it I for internal, E for external? In your list, if you've written it, you will write I for internal beside it and E for external. External circumstances can be society. We think society is holding us. We say, I want to go out for a vacation. Maybe aa gaya, but corona lockdown is not allowing me to live my life. You know, I had a plan to go to UK this year from past 2 years. But because lockdown, the plans all gone, finances all not proper, budget all gone, everything, you know, it's at stake. It's external circumstances. Internally, I was prepared. So again, due to COVID, people are not surviving. People are getting sick or whatever. So it is an external one. It's not in your control. Okay, so some things are external. Fear of your family, people, mother-in-law, spouses, children, parents, you know, all those things are external. They are outside of you. But they are, certain things are inside of us. Clear? So you're easily segregating what is internal and external. So if your reasons you've written are internal, put I on the chat box. I'll know how many people have written internal. And if it is external, write E in the chat box. And if they are both, write B in the chat box. Quickly, only 10 seconds I'll give you, right? I, E, both. Okay, E, both. Both. Okay, cool. Sometimes both. I both. Okay. Okay. Love you. So thank you for participating. And this is super important to be aware what's happening inside and outside. Now, why are we trying to understand? Now, let me come to the story of Louise Hay. The book I was referring to was You Can Heal Your Life. Now it's come in the newer version. Okay, like this. Let me stop share here so that I can see you people. There's a newer version and over 50 million copies have been sold. Besides that, there are plenty of books she has written. Why am I telling you this story? What went? And then few are there on my shelf also. I'll remove all, where will I sit? So I remove only these few. I read them all. And now, in brief, I'll tell you the story of this lady called Louise. She passed away or transited from planet Earth in 2017. And she started her beautiful journey after the age of 40. Till 40, she was struggling. Okay. She was born to a very poor family. External situation, very poor family. Mother was abused by the husband, that is her father. She left, got married to another guy. That guy used to abuse his Louise. She was a 5-year-old child. And she was sexually abused by her stepfather. Plus, she was abused, you know, by the neighbors also. And by the age of 15, There's a long story. You can read in the book. You can heal your life. What I'm trying to figure it out and tell you, put it in your heads, or our heads rather, it's important. However, external situation were her destiny was something else. So we'll come to it. So at the age of 15, she got pregnant. She used to feel unloved all of her life, undeserving all of her life till 15. Matlab, she used to not get enough food, enough good clothes and all. She was made mocked at in the school. And she was seeking that love and approval. And anybody who just used to tell her, oh, you're like good. Thus, you're looking good or doing good. She used to sleep away with them just to get that approval. Okay. And so at the age of 15, she became pregnant. Okay. And 16, she delivered a baby girl. She didn't know how to take care of her. Somehow she found the parents who could adopt the girl child. She gave that baby to the couple and never turned back. And then she ran away from the house because it was too much to bear. Abuse was still on and on. Her mother was not empowered to take care of her. She went away to Los Angeles or Chicago. Okay. And then she was tall and beautiful. Somehow she got some modeling assignment. She groomed herself because of this. Finally, she got her breakthrough in a good modeling company. And she started looking good. Externally, her situation started little changing. Internal stuff, still feeling undeserving, unloved, compromising. Everything is inside, okay? Then an English guy, you know, liked her and he proposed her. She readily said yes. Because like it's a huge thing, you know, some guy, a very rich guy compared to what she was. She married him. Her life surrounded, you know, revolved around this guy. Everything was him. And suddenly after 14 years of marriage, this English man said, I want to divorce you because I found another woman. She was at the age of 40 now. She was back to square one, right? She didn't know what to do because she had given all her hopes, all her dreams, all her life, all her energy to this husband. And this husband, even after getting everything from his wife, found somebody else. She's like, oh my God, what do I do? She stopped her modeling career. Now she's left with no career also. And she was again trying to find out where to find the house and all. So she was staying with her friends. And she used to go to church now. She's like, I need some answer. Why this is happening to me over and over? What have I done wrong? So one of her friends suggested to come for a seminar, okay? So that was a seminar on science of mind, okay? In the churches, you know, not only the Bible was read, there are certain churches, they read science of mind. And she said, okay. She just said, okay, like, you know, she didn't know what was it. She went the other day. A friend who invited did not come and she was here. So how many of you are here? Somebody invited and they are not there and you are here. It happens, you know. It has happened to me quite a number of times. And if you can just scroll down the participants and check, you might feel, oh, he invited, he's only not this. So if you just go through, let me know okay? And she went, there was a 1.5 hour program. Oh, Ms. Khan, oh, okay, yeah, Surbhi must have invited you. Yeah, so the whole session was for 90 minutes. One thing hit her on her head, like rock. The sentence was, your thoughts create your world. Okay? Even we must have heard it, but we must have ignored it. We must have not even taken it seriously. But she was like, oh my God, if my thoughts create my world, what am I thinking all the time? So that means if I change my thoughts, can I change my world? She went on contemplating about it, thinking about it. Uske baad kya bol rahe, kya ho rahe? She didn't bother. It was like running in her head. So in this program, throughout this 90 minutes or 60 minutes, if one thing gets stuck on your head, hold on to it. That will be your life-transforming sentence. Maybe you do not pick up every element of my session here, but you pick up only one. Hold on to it. Go ahead. You will get, you know, I don't know what I can say. There is no stop there. Sky is the limit. Okay, so she started thinking about it and she said, what was the book? The book was Course in Miracles. That's a book. If you can refer, you can refer. I've done the Course in Miracles too. 365 days ka course. So you can just check it out on the Google and find it on. But very difficult to understand, very high level of language. You need to be deeply involved into spirituality to understand. But she just sat with the book, kept on reading, contacted the priests and all the people who were teaching there. Continuously 3 years she was doing study. A Course in Miracles. Okay. And believe me, Rakhi, we cannot do this course alone. We need to do with somebody who has done it. So we have groups and all. If you want, I can refer to that. Okay. So she did 3 years of the study. She's studying and all and everything. And slowly and gradually, her mind is changing. She's changing her thoughts, her belief, our belief patterns are changing. Everything is changing. And now she became a part of a church as a science of mind teacher. You know, there were people who had done this course or something, and now she's a part of it. Now she just collected all the studies. She did the ancient Indian scriptures also reading she did. I realized like they have also studied Indian scriptures. Okay, they are superb. And then she related something, and the book called, if I have it up, yeah, I'll let you pick up. Okay. So her book, the first book was Heal Your Body. Now, this is a very good version. She just had a 15 pages kind of pamphlet kind of a thing. Staple karke, PDF. Nobody was ready to publish a book. Now, this book is all about your diseases, probable thought patterns you have these diseases, and the affirmation. Affirmation means thoughts you can change. So, she just studied everything, created this Bible kind of a thing or a body. And then this book became very famous. Everybody was referring it and getting the results. And then she was like, wow. And then book, somebody got printed for her. And then she first got it only 100 copies. Later, because it went on demand, she got it for 5,000 copies. Somebody got it for her. And she had that confidence ki, yes, this is working with people also. It started working for her. It started working for people. And later on, after 1 or 2 years, she was 45 then, she developed cancer, okay, cervical cancer. Now, this was like, after doing all the work she was doing on herself, doing body and mind connection. Now she's getting cancer. She was like, oh God, what is it? So her coach told her, okay, now it's time for you to really go deep and figure it out. What are the reasons that you develop cancer? And you're going to heal it without going under the knife of a surgeon. She went on deep. She studied nutrition. She studied the pattern. The cancer is too much of holding on resentment, too much of holding on anger. Okay. And she was holding on to it a lot. Because all the men in her life had cheated her, dumped her, used her. And no wonder she got cervical cancer. She was abused at that part so badly. So she had a lot of anger. She did a lot of anger release work, a lot of anger release coach she had. Then she had forgiveness coaches. She did lots and lots of forgiveness exercise. And then after 6 months, when she went to the doctor and she kept on affirming about the cancer, the things are there over here. She went to the doctor. There was not even single cell of cancer in her body. That's amazing. So if you feel like clapping, you can. Oh my God. This, whenever I share this story, I get goosebumps. I really get it. Okay. So we all can understand why am I sharing this story. Okay. And then she wrote her experiences in the book called You Can Heal Your Life. Why? Like, you know, she wrote her story. She wrote her cancer thing. So this is a book which has been sold 50 million copies in different languages all across the world, in our regional languages, other French, Spanish, every language, you name it, it's there. And then she, even this was self-published book, nobody, because she was no one till now. She was just church mein thoda sa counselor coach. Who cares who is she? But then she wrote, and when people started reading her, she started with Hay House Publication, which is a $1 billion company now. She has so many teachers like us under her. So much, a multi-million dollar company, different Hay House America, Hay House India, Hay House Australia, Hay House UK, name it, big company, continent, Hay House is there. Coming to the point, her external situations were bad. If she was not working on her internal situation, life would have been same or may have been not there long back. She died at the age of 92. Her career journey started at the age of 46, actually, the first book. Okay, slowly, gradually, she wrote other. She created workshop modules to help people release their anger, release the fear and all those stuff, and then forgive. And the most of all, started to help people love themselves. Because she knew that all these years, I did not love myself. So I did not take care of my thoughts about my environment. I was giving away. I was being victim of the situation. So understand, let me share my presentation again. So how many people are inspired? If you're inspired, write I. Or if you're raising, and if you're on the screen, yeah, quickly. Yeah, I mean, this is one of the stories which always inspires me. Okay. So understand how many ever E's we have written. If we work on our eyes, the internal limitation, external circumstances have to change. There is but no choice, they have to change. It's all inside. Ye sab andar ki baat hai, you know, it is all inside. All your fears are inside you. All your worries are inside you. All your stresses, all your inferiority complexes, all your guilt. How many of our wrong things we have done? We all have done wrong. She made so many wrong decisions, so many. But the moment she started forgiving herself, giving love to herself, feeling okay for it, the things externally started changing. And if she can do it, I can do it. For me, for my story is a little longer. I will share my heart talk. You can just, if you are interested about my story, I will be sharing the link where I've shared my story for 2 hours. If you have that patience, do let me know. I'll give it to you in a personal chat, okay? So, write inspiring. Yeah, I could see so many inspiring. So, this is the one sentence which hit her like rock on her head. Our thoughts create our reality. So, now, our thoughts create our reality, and now we need to know what are the thoughts we are thinking. So there is a poll again. Let me stop share. Now this time, poll ke liye quickly rehna. What I want is, see, when we say our thoughts create our reality, first of all, sabse important, we need to know what are the thoughts. And if they are very good, keep them. If they are not, change them. Because you know, they are creating their reality. So now will be your awareness exercise or awareness exercise to check out what are your thoughts right now, okay? Or in general, okay? So you have to be quick on the polling thing. Read fast. And here we go. You have only 1 minute. Can you see on the screen? If yes, yeah, thank you. So just put a click if you feel I'm helpless, I have no control. In general, most of the time, how do you feel in any situation? Last 30 seconds. Hi, Surbhi, you're in? How sweet of you. Okay, if you have finished, submit it. If you have not. Okay. For the bigs to get sick. 10%. Quickly, only 20 people have voted. Done. Very good, Surendra. Oh, you got to register and join in. Very nice. Okay, I'm not deserving. 36 people. I hope you can see all the questions. There are 10 questions, okay? Okay. Last 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If you have not submitted, click the submit button now. Just submit it. How many ever answers you've done? No marks. Okay, don't get scared of exam kind of a thing. Yeah, cool. Let us see. You want to see the result? Yeah, let's see. I hope you can see on the screen. Yeah. So I'm helpless. I have no control. 36% feel that. Okay. So I'm probably getting sick is 16%. Nothing would ever happen, 12%. That he or she doesn't really love me, I'll never find love. 28%, it was big time for me. I'm afraid I can't do this, I'm getting so old. Good, and I'm real. I forgot to tell you, be as honest as possible, but you have been really honest. I thought after the story, you'll change your thoughts and tell me something on good. I can't read the other thing. Okay, yeah. I'm terrible. I have no energy. Why can't I find happiness? 24, 52%. I can't stand that person. I'm so angry. I'll never forgive. Okay, this is a big one. And I'm getting old is the next big one. I'm not enough. I'm not happy. All right. Thank you for sharing and being so authentic. This is beautiful. Thank you so much for this. Yeah. Okay. Now we know where we stand, right? So this is the first step. If you have been attending my sessions, then you know first step is awareness. If you're not aware, we do not know what we have to do. So good going. First step kar liya, matlab tumne path chalna shuru kar liya. So congratulate yourself. Okay. Now. So we have approximately 80,000 thoughts in a day. Please don't ask me how we know it. Okay. So science have done the research and all, and I've studied the research paper. So we say 60 to 80,000 is a normal thoughts for everybody, whether I meditate or don't meditate, thoughts are constantly there on my head. And the next surprising element is most of them are negative. What we saw, most of them were negative. And in general, not your thoughts or my thoughts or his thoughts, in general, we have negative thoughts. In general, we have scary thoughts. In general, those thoughts, if we are a little aware, we'll know they're repetitive. Repetitively destructive. A destructive, baki constructive? No. Bar, 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 bar. It will go on creating that repetition of the thought chain. You know, I always say, thought does not come alone. It will come with band, baja, bara. Akela nahi. Thoda dar laga to. Suppose you're scared of corona, you'll be scared of other things. About your finances, about your relation, about your health, about your people's health, about your future. One sort of corona will bring all the barats of the thing related. Okay? So they are generally negative. So this is awareness. So you be aware that this is a thought pattern. Okay? Now, this is important. If we understood, Louise, till the age of 40, she was thinking whatever she was thinking, the old repetitive pattern, because of her external surrounding. Her situation, her reality became like that. So same old thinking will give you same old result. Okay? So if you want different results, you need to do something different. If you do the same thing, same old way, and expect a different result, is it possible? In no way, right? So, like suppose I want to cook sepa bhaji in a different way today, but I use the same ingredients, same method, same steps, same quantity, quality, everything. Will I ever get a new taste? Thank you for nodding. If you can put yes or no, or anything, if I do the same mistake, so this is important. So we say practice makes a man perfect, but perfect in whatever you do. You're doing in the right way, you'll be perfect in the right way. If you're doing a wrong way, you'll be perfect in the wrong way. Practice will make you progress in whatever you're doing. Either you're going up or you're going down. You're progressively going down or you're progressively going up. So if you start with a stress thought and you're practicing stress thought, you're progressively going towards depression. Because you're doing that. But if you have the powerful thoughts and you're practicing powerful thoughts, you're empowering yourself progressively. Empowering yourself and you're changing your pattern. Okay? So this is, oh my God, this is super important. If you feel this is important, right? Yes, it's important. Amazingly important. Okay. So, oh God, this picture says a lot. Thoughts are nothing but stream of inner dialogue. You keep on, there's nobody, but there's something in your head who's keeping on bombarding you. Just bombarding you. And then you like, stop it. You don't even know. You get entangled in the thought and you feel that's your reality. But that's just a thought. Know that, okay? So just constant inner chatter, which is always destructive, which is always negative, always repetitive, if not taken control of. If you're not aware of, if you don't take efforts to change it, this is by default. You know, some systems are by default. And then you need to change in your computer or something. You need to make some changes, add some new softwares, add some more apps or something to make it work better. By default, thoughts are negative. By default, thoughts are repetitive, destructive. Okay. So now, 80,000 thoughts. And we feel it was just one thought, yeah? But know that each thought, just a drop if you put up in the water, it creates a ripple. As I told you, it comes with band, baja, bara. Each thought matter, because if that thought you're not aware of, will bring its barat satme. It will bring people along, the thoughts ke people. Chacha, mama, kaka, nana, nani, sab ko bula ke laega. If you're not allowing it to kick off. Are you getting it? So each thought matters. Are you getting scared now? Oh my God, what am I thinking? If scared, write S in the chat box. Yes, scared, honey. What are you telling us? If you're scared, let me know if you're scared. I'll tell you my story when I realize this fact. Oh my God. Okay. If scared, write S. If not scared, write not scared. Fine, chill. Just put up. Okay, quick. Not scared. Good, Nikita. Not scared. Very good, Sairam. Good. So nobody's scared. Wonderful. Not scared. Okay. I'm not scared. I know these guys are my already old student, not scared. Okay. New guys, please respond, because the more interactive you are, more alert you are in this session, I guarantee the shift in your life only in this 90 minutes. Okay. So be interactive, be responding so that you're aware. Otherwise, your thoughts are going to eat you up. Know that. It's always been doing it. It will always continue to do that. You need to take that step. Okay. Okay. Now next. Let's go. Now, what is the thought cycle? Again, this is next most important thing here to understand. Okay. Not scared. Lovely. Now, thought, how does thought happen? So thought happens in your brain. You keep thinking the inner chattering. If they are very good thoughts, we feel, wow, life is beautiful, life is amazing and all, your feelings will be beautiful. But if they are scary thoughts, you are worried, you are stressed, you are uncertain about the conditions. I am back-to-back COVID, it's coming in my head because that's the only thing in your house, in your surrounding, everybody's talking that. So if your thoughts are worried, vaccination ka number hi nahi aa raha, you know, my husband. Or what if, I mean, after vaccination, I'll be positive. People are dying that way, you know. So if your thoughts are scary, if your thoughts are uncertain, what if this will happen? 2 years aur chalega to fifth wave aaya, second wave ke baad third, fourth, fifth aaya to. If those are your thoughts, that will create feelings in your body. You will feel uncomfortable. You'll feel, I mean, not feel joyful and good. You'll feel not so easy, you know. Uneasiness under hota hai. If you're feeling sad, if your thoughts are sad thoughts, lower vibration thoughts, if you're hurt, you're jealous, you're angry, you're worried, or if you're hating somebody, it will come in your feeling. And once it's repeatedly coming in your feeling, your behavior changes. Have you noticed? Suppose it's your birthday and you're very happy, excited, and all those things, and everybody's trying to take extra efforts to make your birthday good. You feel great, you feel important, you feel wow. And then your behavior, you're more loving, you let go of the problems, you let go of the situations, you know. You are easygoing. But at the same time, if your thoughts are negative and if you're worried about if somebody sick in the house and you have lots of thoughts which are bothering you, or maybe you're yourself sick and you're worried about it, it comes in your feeling and you will get irritated. Har cheez pe gussa, har cheez pe, just leave me alone. Or why are you talking to me so much? You know, something or the other, your behavior changes. So when we look at our behavior or somebody else's behavior, know that it does not rise up on the spot without the process. There is a process. Okay. It starts from a thought, goes to the feeling, comes to the behavior. So if you want to change your behavior, itna gussa karta, you know so many people. Maybe you are a very angry person. Maybe you are a very irritated person. Or maybe you want, you're looking at somebody else. Oh, yes, he keeps irritating all the time. He's always angry. He's always shouting. It can be she also, I'm sorry. And she's always bothering me. Understand what quality of thoughts are going on in their head or in your head. So for now, understand what we're doing this session is for us. Whatever we are going to be aware, we're going to be aware about us. If our behavior at certain moment of time are not empowering, encouraging, happy, or you know, helping people or being together, understand the quality of thoughts mein kuch gadbad hai. So if you just change your brain, I'm fine. You just lie, you put a mask and you say, I'm fine. But under thoughts, wapas wohi chal rahe, nothing will work. It's just a fake thing. You need to work on your thought to change your behavior. And you know, after your behavior, repeated behavior becomes your habit. Repeated habit becomes your character. Same character will become your destiny. Are you getting it? So basically, it's not only thoughts you're working. When you change your thoughts, you change your destiny. It's not only about, okay, I'm feeling taken, I'm bura bhi feel ho raha hai, so big deal. But it is, you are creating your destiny with every thought. So it's super important. Super ka superlative koi aur se batao. It is damn important to be very aware of our thoughts and start working on ourselves. Okay. So this is important. So if you want, you can take the screenshot for yourself or you have noted down. It is important. Okay. This is the crux. Okay. So it says that your inner thoughts create your external reality. Okay. Now we know in this corona time, again, corona, many people have become more millionaire or billionaire. You know, those who have taken the opportunity. Suddenly mask banana chalu, suddenly all the oximeter, suddenly all, they saw the need and they created, and then the things are working. Right? And there are so many people blaming on the situation, not working on the opportunity, thinking it's not in their control, they are helpless, have lost all the savings. And there are fights in the house, there are problems in the home, and all those things is happening. How many feel agree to it? You agree to it? I'll mute everybody. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Say A if you agree to it. You taking tone changes, you have to do. Okay. Yes, 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 yes. Yeah. So our inner thoughts create our inner reality. And we just saw the poll, we saw the result. When we say, I feel helpless, understand your outer reality will make you more helpless. You will get more people who will dominate on you. They will overpower you and they will take the charge of your life, because inner thought, inner dialogue is, I am helpless. So you are attracting the people, the situation, the thing, and then you'll say, dekha, how can I help? He's only behaving like that. Corona mujhe hi hona tha. Mere boss ne mujhe fire karna tha. Are you getting it? So why those situations happen? Because my belief, my thought is I'm helpless. And then those kind of people will come. But if I feel I can always, I have the power to change my reality. You will get people who are going to lift you up. Will show you your strength. Will show you you can also do something about it. And then you will work on your qualities, what you have already. Correct? So all the thoughts which you have written are creating your reality, that now we are aware. Now our job is to work and change this thought. You cannot probably change your outer reality. Louise, hey, changed the outer reality. She left the house. She left the child. She said, because of the child, I'll be stuck. Because of mama, I'll be stuck. She went, because of the city, I'll be stuck. She changed her city. She went to a glamorous world. Okay, maybe when people will look my beauty and all, they'll love and appreciate me, my life will be better. She changed the external thing. Internally, she was still feeling, I'm not good enough, I'm not worthy, I'm undeserving. Somehow she got married because of her beauty or whatever. But ultimately, she was left again. Her external reality changed again. Because, and the moment she started really working on inner, the things kept on changing. I'm not saying it will change. One day you change and next day, sabko jadu chhu matar ho jayega. You will be staying in the palace or you will get some Prince Charming coming and rescuing you. No, no, no. Okay? It's a process. It's a process. The 80,000 thoughts a day, and we have been thinking for past 30, 40 years, at least we'll give 1/10 of our time to change our reality. It's a process. We need to be aware. We need to work on those things. Now we are aware. Now, iska kya kare yani? You told me, okay, now what do I do? That should be your question, isn't it? So that you can change your reality. So this part is like, you know, when you're building up your spellings, when you're building up your sentences, your ABCD has to be strong. Your sound phonetics should be strong so that you can create your spelling and the sentence. So this is your foundation. If you understand this, you know how important it is to work on your thoughts, on your belief system. If you've taken hold of this, that's what Louise does. The things will work. It will work. You will get the right kind of coaching. You'll get the right kind of processor. You'll get the right kind of books or the courses or somebody like, you know, my sessions. And the process will begin. Okay, so this is important to understand. Okay, so this is about the poll we took. So imagine if we chose to think, nobody loves me, I'm undeserving. What will be our outer reality? Will it be really good? Will it be helping us live the life of our dream? Absolutely no. Even if one you picked up yes, even if you said yes to one, and I'm sure some of them, three to five to submit it kiya hoga, you know. It could be that also. That is a quality of our thought to understand our quality of life. Okay? And if you cannot catch your thought, 80,000, isko pakru, you will get, oh my God, don't give up. Check the quality of your life. Check the people in your life. Check your house. Check your support you're getting. Check how many compliments or things you're getting. How easy is your life? Or how struggle is your life? If you have lots of struggle and all, understand quality of thoughts make gadbad hai. Locha wahan pe hi hai. Okay? But if you're having a comfortable life, if you're having a life where people are supporting you, people are there for you, and money is always there. I'm not saying maybe not like a money, but whenever you need it, it's there. Health, very good health. If that is a thing, that means your quality of your thought is good. So in the beginning, it is difficult to catch hold of your thought. Out of these, there are plenty more. If you can, wonderful. If you cannot, check your quality. Which area are you feeling from 0 to 10? Only 1 or 2. You know, this area is not working. Maybe my relationships never work. Maybe I'm always falling sick. How much ever care I take, but I'm always falling sick. Or maybe I do so much for others, but nobody cares. And I'm not loved. You know? So if that is the thing, be aware and just make a note of it in your notebook. You don't have to share with me. It's your reality. If you're okay to share, by all means you can, but at least write it in your notebook. Which area of your life is showing the picture to you? This is a place you need to change your thoughts. You need to change your beliefs. Okay? Just a minute. Write it down. If it's getting heavy, tell me heavy. If it's okay with my speed or content, say okay. Okay? Because it's touching our cords. If it's feeling heavy, write heavy. Otherwise, say okay. Okay. Well, let me check the responses. Okay. Thank you. Is it possible to get in from negative to positive? Okay, thank you. Okay, so if you've noted, very good. I'll go ahead because there's still lots more to cover. I mean, I can say I'm very ambitious. I want to give so much to you guys, you know. With the photo limit, man, you can't have a full day thing, at least 90 minutes. So there was a question just now on the chat box. Can these thoughts be changed? And the answer is yes. And that's all. That's a living example. Those who know my story, you'll know it. And those who do not, please go through my heart talk. I will share the link towards the end. Just click it there and save that link. And so if you choose to think differently, if you choose to affirm differently, because your thoughts create your words, you know, your words are your running physical thoughts. If you're affirming constantly, it's affecting thoughts. We are going reverse me. You know, thoughts create, thoughts aate bolte, they become your words. You can't go and change in your head. Okay, thought, go change. You change your words. And keep thinking consciously those words. Maybe they are not your reality, but consciously create that reality. Example, my thought, current thought is I am helpless. I have no power. That is creating a reality which is making me a victim. So I will choose the thought, I have the power to change my reality. Keep on repeating that thought. And then the new reality will be formed in my head and then in my life. Are you getting it? So it's a good news that yes, thoughts can be changed. And by consciously choosing to affirm different thoughts, we can create our different reality. And now I'm going to show you how. Okay? So now, this is important. Imagine if we chose to affirm I'm successful in whatever I do. Like it's in my head. I take a session, I am successful, no matter what. Maybe my PPT goes wrong, maybe it's power failure, or, but I'm sure ki I will touch the heart of people because I'm doing from my heart. It has to work. Maybe external circumstances support me, don't support me, but my thought or affirmation in my head is, my sessions touch the hearts of people. They will bring the shift in their life. So what is that reality going to create? Similarly, I plan my work and work my plan. If I have that thought, I'm structured, I'm creating that thing. And I focus on what is truly essential. Imagine if we have these kind of thoughts always running in your head, how would be your life? Just write one word, how would be your life? How would be your outer reality? Any one word comes to your mind, just put up on the chat box.
Beautiful.
Beautiful, awesome, yeah. Please, could you say that to your phone? No. These are some affirmations, darling. I'm not going to specify till now, Sangi. This is in general. The life will be beautiful, fulfilling. Okay, awesome, blessed. Yes. Look at the words. Meaning, now you tell me. Choosing these thoughts, is it in our control or somebody else's control? Say ROC or our control. Or not OC, our control. Okay. Our control. Because who is thinking in my head except me? Can somebody just open my head and put go inside and think? No ways. Can I go inside your head and think, come on, think positive thoughts, I'm there inside you? No. It's like you are thinking in your head and you can choose to change your thoughts. Who's telling you not to? Who's holding you? So now we know our thoughts are creative. We have the power. Maybe we cannot change this corona, but I can change my thoughts to think about it differently. To create my reality different. I'm not talking about entire world's reality. I'm talking about our world. Our thoughts create our world. Your world and my world are different. Globally, we are on the same world. But I have different sets of people in my house, different sets of work ethics, work. Everything is different. My world is different. It is different in my head, different in reality. So if you want to change your world, some parts in our world may be really working good. Some parts are really struggling. We need to check on which are struggleful and change those thoughts and create the world of our dreams. Make sense? Right? MS if it's making sense. If it's making sense, right, MS, so that I can proceed further, because this is an empowering statement. Okay? It's my thought. I choose to think differently from now. You can make a note of it. I choose to think differently from now. It's my choice. Even if I'm jailed, I'm locked up in the locker or somewhere, I'm starving, but I still choose to think thoughts which are good for me, which are empowering for me. How on earth did Gandhiji create a plan for independence in the jail? He was locked up. I don't know what kind of food he was getting and all, but constantly he was thinking, I have to do something for my country. He was thinking those thoughts. He was planning Dandi March. He was planning all the satyagraha and everything. But no matter where you are, you can choose in your head to think thoughts you want to think. That is your power. Okay. Is it in something? Okay, MS. Makes sense. Yeah. Okay, let's go ahead. Negative thoughts are often filled with. Okay. I'm again negative because jab tak hum negative ki clarity pe nahi aayenge, we cannot go to the positive. So when you're into negative thoughts, we are always filled with guilt, shame, or we feel bad, we feel unfulfilled and all those things. So we judge ourselves. You know, we try in our thoughts, might be we are working or seeing the things outside, but deep down when I do my personal sessions, so there are a few people over here also, they are present here. When I do personal session and lead to the question, I just will ask question. I'll not give any suggestion because I know all the answers are within each one of us. Okay. And when those empowering questions are asked, finally, whatever problem is, the problem comes, I'm not good enough. Maybe I'm not doing enough. Maybe, you know, the because you're thinking bad about yourself. You're thinking negative about yourself deep down. And you feel dumb. You feel stupid. You feel, I'm lazy. That's why I'm not doing it. And how will you do when you have the thoughts that say that you are lazy? Even after doing full morning to evening, you're doing all the work. But thoughts are lazy because somebody in the childhood, somebody in the adulthood, maybe your husband, maybe your sasuma, or maybe your teacher, maybe your neighbor, you're a lazy dumb. You cannot do anything. Said once and you thought this is my reality. Even after achieving so much, you feel I'm not doing good. How can you do good then? Right? So negative thoughts will generally judge you. Even if people come to me that I hate somebody, I'm angry on that, I cannot forgive. Ultimately, it's about the self. You cannot be okay with your own self. Futurely, if I take those sessions, I come to the point. And in 100%, not even 99%, I'll say, 100% problem hoti hai, you are holding that judgment, criticism about your own self. About your own self. And it comes from so many things that we have in our workshops and all. That detail, I just can't go here. Yeah, Surbhi. Thank you. So now there's another question. You need to, I'll give you only 2 minutes. Your ideal self, okay? What is your ideal self? So you need to write now on top of your page, write I should. Okay? Write I should. Number one, I should be getting up early in the morning, making my people happy, or whatever. Whatever comes to your head. I should be a very good mother, very good. Anything coming in your head, any 2 minutes, just short form me likho as if there's no time. Okay, but write it fast. And if you are okay to share with me on the chat, please put up on the chat box. I should be extraordinary person. I should be growing successful. Okay, last 1 minute. I should focus on my diet and exercise. Okay, I should be calm mother. Okay. Good. Right, few more. At least 3 to 5. I should start valuing and loving myself. Okay. I should be miraculous person. Confident, happy, loved, successful. Should be more relaxed. Should be more energetic. Should be accepting. Should have successful career. Okay. Arzu, you sound new to me. Is it for the first time you're attending? If yes, say first. Just write first. Yes. Okay. 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 Last 20 seconds. Empowered myself, blissful, help my community to be empowered, should be abundant, should be confident, I should be active, proactive, amazing, other center, helpful, loving, caring. Me too. Should be less judgmental. Yes. I should be stop criticizing. Yes. Okay. Okay. Maine pehle hi list lena tha. I should be able to complete my dad's dream. Okay. I should write about. All right. Stop. Okay. Okay. Yeah. So we made a list. And thank you for sharing with me and the group here. Should be energetic, successful, happy. Okay. Cool. I'm really glad that you shared here. And Now, know that all the should list comes because you feel you're not doing something right. So if I do this, that is my should list. I should be doing something right. Okay. It's coming from your own self or listening to maybe my session just now. Some people said I should be loving myself more. Or it could come from the parents. Okay. Vishalji, you did not write. So, you know, even after you have grown up already, but you feel you should be more active because my mother says I'm lazy. Okay. Or you feel you are doing wrong or somebody else is doing wrong. Okay. So that is a should list. Should list is always making yourself or others feel wrong. So politicians should be working very decently, honestly, or country should progress the big ways. Okay. I should be doing something for my country. I should be doing this thing. Perfect. Okay. This is a good thing. We have something sentiments for our country. Good. But what is it? Successful in business and personal. Yeah. Okay. Now, why do you think we should be doing it? Now, just one more minute and write why. Whatever you've written, Tell me why you should be doing it. Why that should. Only 1 minute. And all these things are super important. If you can put up on the chat box, I'll be really glad to read, because I want to complete. Complete what, beta? Achha, because I want to complete the Papa Ka project, okay? For self-satisfaction, okay? For myself, okay? To complete my work on time, okay? Why do you want to complete work on time? Ask next why. Okay, to be happy, okay? Be happy to fulfill my dreams, okay? Want to be feeling peaceful, because it makes me anxious, which is resulting in stress and anxiety, because I'm impatient and motivated for my progress, fulfill my duties to a family, should be able to take more responsibility, caring and good listener, also a lot of money, okay? To make my and others' life easier, and it's my nature. Okay, because to be happy and get positivity abundance in life, okay, I should become because I'm feeling, I'm not, and I want to become because of that, okay, so that I can give something to society. All right, thank you, time up. Thank you for participating and going inside and checking your truth. There is some unrest within me which gets unsettled and should be something because I like peace and peace. All right, got it. So there are some shoulds because I want to make others happy. I want to make everything easy and all that. And some are because I want to do it for myself. Okay. Let's go. Why am I asking this? Okay. So some idea says I should be successful, getting where I want to, doing what I need to, becoming a calm mother, whatever the list we have, 1, 2, 3, so many we have. Actually, what are we? Okay. So you'll write in a minute, actually, how am I? Should be versus reality. Archana, it was like what you should be doing. That was the first question. Next question is, what is your reality? What are you actually doing? I'm so lazy, judging, not accepting others as they are. Okay. A bit lazy and excuse making sometimes. Okay. Wow. It takes lots and lots of courage to first of all go inside and check your reality. Next, courage to share it in the group where you don't even know each other. At least when we used to have the physical workshop, we used to first half an hour, we used to meet each other. Everybody used to get friendly because you're sharing our secret selves. Okay. But here we don't even know. And you guys are really awesome. I must say that. No buttering. Okay. It really needs courage. You know it. It's the second courage, right? Okay. Okay. I got meant to the next slide. Okay. Sometime doubt to believe. Okay. Shaken by external circumstances. Okay. So example are there here. I should be more organized, more caring. I should not be making mistakes, earn more money, common to most of us, lose weight. I should be more assertive. And when you have lots of should in your life, this is important to know. When you have lots of should in your life, the life becomes rigid, you know, it becomes a set of expectations from your own self. And you're not happy because you're not able to fulfill that expectation. Reality may you want to achieve those promotions. You want to earn that much money. You want to be the best of mom. You want to be calm. But you've not worked on your anger. You've not worked on your hurts. You've not worked on your real skills that you have. You're doing something which you were told to do, but you do not know what is your real passion. And we expect to get the results from that. We might get a salary, but the millions and billions will come when you follow your passion. We don't even know that. But you're on the career or the path where we should be on that. We should do some professional degree like CA, engineer, doctor, because everybody's doing. Maybe I didn't know I want to be a doctor, suppose. Or maybe I wanted to be a painter. But I'm into this field and I'm expecting big money from there. You will not get because you're not doing from your heart. You cannot be a calm mother when you are, you're caught up with your own hurts. your own insecurities, your own belief system from the past, your feeling of unlove. How will you give that love? How will you be calm when so much struggle is going inside? You should not be judging others when the fact is constantly we are judging ourselves. I should be a greatest actress. But I'm not doing enough, so I'm not satisfied. I'm getting frustrated and I cannot see my truth because I'm wearing that mask. I'm looking at others and judging others. He's not doing it. She's not doing it. And all those things. Are you getting the clarity on this? Are you getting it? Okay. So when we have lots of shoulds, we have lots of expectations from ourselves. And then there's a long gap between the real reality and expectation, which causes all the gadbad in every area. It could be your relationship, your finances, your health, and everywhere. Make sense? If yes, type yes. Makes sense. So that I'll come how to fill in the gap. What are we here for? To fill in the gap. Too much of expectation. I'm working as a teacher and I want to earn millions of rupees. Who will give me? Not even the international school. So I have to do something different. I have to polish my skills. I have to find out my passion. Work on it. I've been doing this from 2014. Isn't it 14? My passion follow 15 millionaire ban gaya. No. There are too many things. But now you know that is my path. So you need to be sitting with yourself, checking out what is it. Learn it. Take all it takes to really become best in your industry. If your money is your goal, if calmness is your goal, you need to attend meditation classes. You need to find out how these people are always calm and happy. What are they doing? What am I not doing? And start doing it. But know there is a gap to be filled. You can't jump. You'll fall down in the valley and will do nothing ever. It's a process of awareness. How much I'm expecting? What is my current reality? I have to walk through the path. It is a process. Nobody can make it in a day. And we know that Rome was not built in a day. We are Rome for our own self. We are the palace in our own body. We have to create, carve it, beautify it. Provided if you're ready for it, to understand it. Okay. Makes sense. Holding on to past here. Okay, let's go ahead. Okay, so when we are not what we think we should be, we feel very anxious, we feel guilty, and we have all the emotions which will not lead us to take positive action. We feel I'm dumb. Even if I know it, I can't do it. 10 years, I'm only dreaming to become this. I'm not doing, because there's a lot of gap. And in this gap, it's filled with a lot of negative emotions. And you know, with your negative thoughts, negative emotion, you cannot have positive behavior. You cannot take positive action. Even if you do some action, it won't be effective. The results don't show up unless you go and work on your belief system. Do you connect with this? If you feel, yes, I connect, right? Connect there. Or just write, yes, I know. You connect with this in your own life. Forget Louise, forget mine, forget everybody. Yeah. This is important. If you connect and you know it, I need to, fill in the gap. And it is a wider gap. We have already 30, 40, 50 years of age. Who's the youngest one? Maybe 30, I think. Nobody's younger than us. Anybody below 30 years? Even if you're below 30, I don't know. I doubt there is one. Because these kind of workshops or places are for those people who are ready to take a next jump in our life, It has to be 35 and above, If there is some younger, that is amazing. By age, darling. By heart, I'm 2 years old. Okay. So understand? Now we know the process, okay? I know you're waiting for that. Sab taali ki ek chabi, love yourself now. Okay? How much of a gap there is? Maybe you are here, you want to go there. You cannot go there if you constantly criticize yourself, because that's a negative emotion. If you constantly judge yourself, you cannot travel the path. You cannot go ahead. Now, I have different 10 points how to really love yourself. All 10 points should be scribbled on your head. I'll share the link to my playlist. Okay, that was a good workshop I had taken some years ago. I've created small, small bite-sized videos. I will share with you. All the videos are super important. 2 minutes ke hai, telling you what are the points you need to take. The first one is, which is the most important, never. Jitni baar never likhna hai, likho. Criticize yourself. Bold mein criticize yourself. That's the first step. Because the moment you criticize yourself, you're creating the bigger gap. You're stopping the process to go towards your dream. Are you getting it? If you cannot do, say, I'm willing to learn. And there's so many things I have to learn. You will have to learn. We all have to do it. But be willing, and be willing to do it, not because you should be doing it, but because you want to do it, because you love yourself, and you want to have the life of your dreams. That's why I'm doing it. Not because I'm not good enough, I'm bad, I've been failing all the time. Ab to mai wo karke dikhana. No. Go slow, but go lovingly, go peacefully. You will get the right mentor. You will get the right course. Take the courses also. You cannot do on yourself. You know how much I've invested my time, money, energy on getting deep into myself. Many gurus, you name it, I've been to most of them. Bigger, bigger courses, international courses. Taking all the books, almost there are more than 150. And e-books, I have plenty. Audiobooks, I have plenty. I've been doing that. Not because I'm not good enough, but because I want to grow. If you were there from the beginning, I love myself the way I am, and I still want to grow and shine in the world. Because I'm beautiful, I'm capable, and be my best, okay? So we all need to learn. There is no stop to learning. But which space are we coming from? Are we coming from the space, I hate myself, people hate me, I want to prove it to others that I can do it? Or you love yourself and you want to experience all the goodness of life. Okay. So all those people who want love yourself ka videos, you do text me. I hope you all have my WhatsApp number. Okay. So that was all. So basically that thing will lead to takeaway from today's session. You need to tell me 3 things you learned. 3 main important things. I know so many we learned. What are the key things you learned in this program? And what is the one thing which you are going to surely apply? Quickly, you might unmute or you might type. And there are a few more things which will help you in this journey. Stay here. My thoughts create my reality. Won the video. Suman Bhagat, you have my number. Everyone.
Your thoughts can be changed by affirmation. That was a very important point.
Your okay, lovely. Yeah. Are you affirming
by affirmations?
Time? Yes. Lovely. 8 4 5 2 00 7 2 1 3. Thought cycle was so important. Yeah. My number I'm sharing for those who do not have my personal number. Everybody, those who want the videos or something, please message me on my number. WhatsApp me, okay? And please say, understanding things not in your control. Good. Okay. Key things, everybody, there are 38 people. I want 38 things. I shared, beta. Neetu, can you see up? Just scroll up. And please say, hi, I'm so-and-so attended your session. Or maybe I'll create a WhatsApp. Can I stop? I'll stop here and come back to this. Self-love is so important, Surbhi. Super important. Appreciate myself, love myself. I'm not the last on the list. No negative thoughts. So many takeaways. Awesome. Don't. Okay. Okay. Am I sharing something? I don't want to share something. Okay, so I'm reading Ravi Bhomkar. You're new to me. Thoughts create your world to change your life. Thoughts here. Self-love. Yeah. Okay, who else? Next, everyone need to write. I'm checking who has not written. Okay. Now, last few things. Share present. You are your bestie. Yes, spend time with yourself. Love yourself. Always love yourself. Oh, wow, the Amanda ji coming from you is superb. You know, guys are a little shy, about talking love yourself. They feel it's too girlish, but it is not. It's equally important for boys as well. Everything was a takeaway. Sairam, cool. Love yourself should be ideal self, not thought cycle. Extra. Hey, pura summary ho gaya. Cool. Our thoughts can be changed. Okay, okay. Lovely. I love your participation. So if you want to be, you know, all these members, 37. So I'm 31. What is this? You've created the group. Okay. Join this group so that we all are there. I'll be sharing all the material, the recording link. There are a few PDFs of affirmation which I can share with you. There is Love Yourself ke liye that program which I'll be sharing with you. Only if you're there in the group, I'm not going to search people outside. I have little, quite a few things. Just click and join that thing or copy the link or something. Now I have a few more things to share. Okay. So takeaways. I thought of writing it. I said, nay, let me see if that is my understanding. I want people's understanding. So I left your takeaway for yourself. And let me go ahead. Okay. So what I'm going to share is this. Now we have opportunity to dive deeper. Okay. We understood. You know, there is a gap. My reality and my dream life. So Heal Your Life or You Can Heal Your Life, Louise's program, are always about the deeper understanding. So we have created, we as in the Heal Your Life people, you know, it's from America, created for world over, world-class product. It's 5-week online journey. First week, we work on deservability. Okay, the full week, we have the meditation, affirmation, coming from the belief system. What do you believe about your deservability? Okay, if you do not know that, you cannot change it. And then how to change, how to become more deserving. Okay. Second week, we work on love and relationship. They are the most important part of our life. If we don't feel love, our relationship are not in place, we feel useless or worthless. So again, we come from what you believe about love. We check on our thoughts. You know, if your thoughts are good, our love will be good. If our thoughts have some hanky-panky things, our relationship will have lots of hanky-panky things. So there is, again, a meditation, visualization, affirmation, working, changing your belief system into the new belief system. Third, after love, money is super important. We know it is important whether we agree it or no. Or we see money is the root of all evils. Or we can say money is Lakshmi Ma. You know, it is how are your thoughts about money. We really work together on understanding what are our thought patterns. Or are we living with money? Are we attracting? Or are we running after money? All those things will be discussed in the third week. And we will change our belief system. And they work wonders, okay? Fourth week, we have loving your body. Health is next most important thing. We can't ignore. We have all the money, all the love, but no health. We can't be happy again. So where is my health issue coming from? I've asked people, so what are diseases you're going through? I have diabetes. Oh, my mother had, my nanny had. It's running in our family. So what are you believing? What are your thoughts? Out of 10 children or 5 children or 3 children, why you have it? It's for the family. Everybody should have it. So it's not only a genetic. It's nothing called genetic. Doctors are made in that way. It's how are you thinking? Understand, when cancer can be healed, anything can be healed. Okay? So that's what we are working on. We are working on your own unhealthy ailments. I'll mute everyone. Fourth one. This looks my honoring our boundaries. Honoring our boundaries is very important. Especially Indian women, I don't know, men also cannot say no to everyone easily. It is, haan, sabko please karna hai. Wo dukho gaya to, usko bura laga to, usko ye hua to. Arre, where are your boundaries? Where are you going to say no to? Only when you say no to certain thing, you can say yes to yourself. So you will identify where I have to put my foot forward and be a yes man or a no man, right? So this is important. So for me, when I did this, I have done this journey 5 times. All together, and I'll be doing 6M again with you guys if you join in now. Deservity and honoring boundaries were big time thing for me, you know. And as I'm opening up in deservity, the things are working out. As I'm learning to say no, people are not taking me for granted. Otherwise, kabhi bhi call karo, kabhi arey, where will I do mama? Sabke call utha ke unke do arey ruko. Text me, WhatsApp me, am I available? So even though I know I'm compassionate, but I'm compassionate towards myself also, right? So that is how we need to understand that. So I want few people who have taken this journey so that you know the clear sense of it. So who would like to share? And you will share what is your name, how was your life before taking this journey, and what happened during the processes, and how is it life even now after completing your journey last year or whatever. Is the impact over after 5 weeks or is this continuing? Sangeeta will go. Yes, thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Sangeeta. By profession, I'm a teacher and a science and a math teacher. So I am in the path of spirituality since 3 years with Honey only. So before joining with Honey, so I was very sensitive. I used to get hurt by very small, small things and just tears rolled out. That was my biggest weak point. And everybody used to mock. What? Hamesha roti rehti hai ki thoda baat mein rona hai padne. Like that, I used to feel bad. But didn't find way how to come out from that. I'm very family oriented towards my kids. So one fine day, 2018, I got enrolled in the parenting group where I came in contact with Honey and started attending the webinars. And slowly, slowly, thoughts started changing. But a major shift came when I joined last year, July 2020, when I joined the Heal Your Life course, which just now Honey explained you that that's a 5 week course. And all thanks to the lockdown, actually. The lockdown gave me a lot of time for myself. Before that, I was not giving time myself. I was going through a series of health issues. Sometimes slip disc or something, knee pain or something or the other. It was just minor, but I was very irritated with that. What? Why me only? Why I am only going through these pains one after the other and just ek gaya to dusra aa gaya. So I was little irritated from within, and that was to spill out also on my kids, on my family. And I really wanted to get over all these things. I didn't like all that things. So this happened. This course happened to me actually at that juncture when I was literally irritated from inside. So I enrolled this course on July 2020, and it went on for 6 weeks actually. So this course, this 5 week course, was really brought a major shift in my life. I could actually brought awareness on my thoughts. Pehle lagta hai paise to bahut kash par, I have to do lot of things to get the money. Many belief system was there, and I had lot of anger for few people, which I didn't realize. That realization was not there when I went through this process. Each process was so super designed, pelui hai, and really I enjoyed the process. The meditation of disability was just super, super awesome. That was the first chapter that touched my heart actually. So that affirmation still I do. Every time now what happens is I have a bigger shift in my life, not only on me, but my loved ones are also changed. When I see them becoming negative or something negative they are telling, I try to change their thoughts. It's little difficult, but I don't give up. Wow. I just try to bring the shift in them. Maybe 1%, 2% or anything. At least thoda shift ho gaya to mujhe bhi acha lagta hai ki maine shift laya. I feel proud of myself. I give a pat.
Yeah, you remember. Wow.
So that's a bigger shift actually. Still working on. I am still working. I attend each and every session that are conducted by Honey. Mm-hmm. I feel some takeaway will be there from each session. I learn something more. So that's my journey. Still going on to being a bigger and a great version of myself in the near future.
Okay. Now, Sangeeta, one more minute. You joined my 7-day quest also.
Right.
Yeah. Can you brief about that as well? So yeah, we have a 7-day program which I'm going to declare right now. Let Sangeeta complete and I'll be discussing about that. Yeah.
7-day quest, just recently we completed the 7-day quest. That is a heart quest. That basically from that quest, I learned that awareness, that is a major thing. Awareness on our negative thoughts. In a day, many thoughts come out. Ye to mere sath hota hai. Yeah, sometimes my son or daughter does something. Tera aadat aise hi hai. So like that is general talk. We generally talk, but we don't think, we don't understand that thoughts become negative or wo waisi karne lag jata hai. That awareness came after joining the 7-day quest. So there one activity was the rubber band activity. So kuch bhi negative aaya to humko khud ko marna hota hai. So next time lagta hai, aaya yaad aaya to arey inko marna hoga. So I have to just change my thought at that moment. So slowly by the end of 7 days, that negative thought became less. I can't say it became zero. But became less, that much I can say. And my positive intelligence became up. Okay. So many things were there in that belief system were there, which we changed. Then there were different states. We could understand it, which state we are. We are in the victim mode or what. So that things came, the shift came in it and still working out in it.
Still working. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing here. Yeah. God bless. And thank you for joining your course. And thank yourself that you're taking that huge step. Honestly, thank you, Sangeeta. But everybody, you need to stay for a few more minutes. If you're getting late, stay there. I told you it can go up to 7 o'clock. And you will get something extra towards the end. So stay connected. So basically, it's not, you know, Sangeeta has been connected. It's not one day journey. It's not one program journey. It's like there is layer after layer which works. And then you open up and go deeper. So the gap, what is there, you know, about your... should be, and your true self is getting lesser and lesser, and you're reaching your ideal self. And how are you traveling? You're doing it out of love. You're being aware and you're okay with it, accepting it, and still growing. Isn't it, Sangeeta? That's how it's happening, you know? So it's important. And in both the cases, you know, whether it's a 7-day quest, I need to share about the 7-day quest also, which I did not a minute. So I have another program. I never do two programs together, discussion, but I have to, because both are so important. Okay. So this is like I've called a 7-day quest, where in 7 days we meet for 20, 30 minutes and I'll give you some growth work where we are jumping from being victim to the surrounding, to the situation, to the people in our life or to our own thoughts, to empowering ourselves, right? And we take this journey together. And all the tools and techniques, how to do it, will be given in there. You know, it won't be that I'll be teaching. There will be no teaching. Only the brief. And then you have to do the work. Activities will be there. The things will be there. If you don't do the work of first day, you cannot join the second. You have to complete it, submit it, and then go to the next. Because it's a committed action. It is not that you just watch it. Thank you very much. No, it's about commitment to your growth. And you, as you, did you notice when Sangeeta said, when I changed, the family is also changing, right? The family is changing. You don't have to go and change. Your intention will be changing yourself. And the byproduct is your situation change. Your people will love and respect you more. People will be understanding. Your goal will not be that. If your goal is that, you will never reach it. But when your goal is coming from yourself, loving yourself, working on yourself, things will fall in place and you were like, ye to magic hai, kaise ho raha hai? How are things falling in place? Because universe is working for you now. You are a part of the universe. Now you took responsibility of yourself. Now it's universe's responsibility to give you all that you needed. Are you getting it? So it is so important. I want somebody else also to share so that we get a brief picture, whatever program you've attended and whatever shift you've got in your life. So who will go next? Can I have Rakhi will go next. Okay, Rakhi. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Rakhi. Hi. And I'm a housewife. So I joined Honeymiss maybe like 8-9 months back. So, and it has brought a big shift in my thought process. So now, I would like to tell you about this Louise Hay course. This is a 5-week course, but it brings a big difference in your life. Why? Because what I found it, I could not complete it. I'm still in the process of completing. We get 6 months to complete. We can complete it in like maybe a month also, maybe in 6 months also. So it's all up to us. It's a very easy course to do. It seems to be easy to do, but it is actually not easy because when you start doing it, it takes you deep inside yourself. You get to understand a lot of your perspectives, lot of your beliefs, which you have been carrying with you since your birth probably. So this happened with me because when I joined, I came across so many things, and I realized that the beliefs that I'm carrying are not like, you know, 10-year-old or 15-year-old beliefs. They're actually the beliefs that I have been putting into in my system since probably when I was a child. When my parents used to speak something, the neighbors used to speak something, friends used to speak something. And now I can feel all those things happening around me. So I could connect with my belief system and the things happening around. So what effect this course brought in me, though I'm still halfway through only, but I can see a big shift in my own thinking. First thing is, I'm more aware of my thoughts. Secondly, the way I have started taking day-to-day problems, like we all have families, we all go through a lot of problems. Sometimes it's with the spouse, sometimes it's with parents or in-laws or children or with ourselves also. We, as we today learned, like we criticize ourselves a lot. But then this course made me understand that, okay, even if I'm criticizing myself for a moment, I am aware of changing my thought to praising myself in the very next moment. And this all thing brought a big shift in my behavior in the house itself. I have found a big change in my relationship with my husband, with my children. The best I see it is because I have changed my own thought process. I have improved on my patience level. I have improved on my the words, you know, like the I used to get irritated and bombard my children with something like you are nuisance and you don't listen. But I'm more patient and I lose my temper like at the last juncture, I would say. So I have learned that, and this has brought a change that, okay, my kids are learning the same thing. Because we have to be polite, you know, we don't have to accept, we don't have to speak wrong things. We have to be positive. That is the biggest thing my children are learning, that we have to be aware of our thoughts. We have to change our negative thoughts into positive. We have to affirm things. So affirmations work. They have started believing in universe. And yeah, because, you know, this was never the case in my family before that. And now I have seen a change in my husband's thought process because he has started understanding all these things. He has started cooperating me. Like today, when I'm joining, this is my dinner time in the house and I should be preparing. But none of them is coming and telling me, you know, you are getting late or this or that. They are helping me, cooperating me to attend the sessions because they're seeing that positive change. I have really developed a very positive change with my husband. I tell him everything, but in a very different, loving and, you know, happy manner. He doesn't mind listening to it and he accepts what I am saying.
One minute. There's a disturbance. I'm just muting. Okay. And you need to unmute yourself. And so basically, if you want to tell people, okay, yes, how is it going to help them?
Yes, so this course will help you in understanding your own self, in understanding your inner belief system and changing it. This is certainly going to help you in making your present life happy and a positive one, because the change will not be around in the people around you, but the change will be within you. And this Louise Hay journey is seriously once in a lifetime thing. I would really request everybody to please join it at least once and see the difference in yourself. Even that doing maybe 2 weeks, 3 weeks you might be able to do, but this will certainly show a difference in yourself and you will be inclined towards it and doing more of such courses. So I would really request everybody to go through his journey, because Louise Hay journey is something which is really powerful and it will... It brings a huge shift in your life.
And how we used to have those sessions, you know. So do you think it can be given and we shouldn't be meeting, or do you feel meeting was important?
No, I feel we used to meet once a week with Miss, because when we see the course, it seems to be very easy. But when we do, we come across lot of challenges in the form of, like, you know, something is stopping you from them. Either some work comes up, some commitment comes up, something or the other. But still, when you meet once a week and the teacher is holding you, you know, she is explaining you certain things. She's motivating you to move ahead. That is the biggest thing that you need, which in my words, I call it always hand holding. So we always need hand holding from somebody, you know, like teacher just said that maybe your guru or somebody or friend or anybody. So for me, it's Honey Miss. And she has really brought a big difference in my life. So I feel ki, you know, meeting once in a week also brings a change. Then we used to have the WhatsApp group. Usme bhi people, you know, they tell each other, they support each other a lot. So it brings a big change in everything. You even if something is stopping you, the people in the group or the Honey Miss itself, she will pull you through it. You know, you have to move ahead. Don't stop in between. And then the point will come that you yourself will push you yourself that you know, I have to move ahead because I'm seeing that positive change within me.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Rakhi. Thank you. It will help many people here. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you.
So everyone understand the course is by itself self-paced design. You can complete the validities for 6 months. You can complete in your own way. But when I got to know that this course is there, I understood that there needs to be some accountability, some hand-holding, that somebody asks you, how is it going? And where are you getting stuck? So what we have the structure as, we meet 6 weeks. Courses for 5 weeks. First is week zero, wherein I'll be there to help you how the course will go through. You know, how are you going to begin? Which 10 minutes of the day you're going to take out? It is 10 to 20 minutes you're going to take it out. And if you're not able to, you'll be authentic and telling me in the group, you're not able to, then I'll be just getting your time from your busy schedule that you need to do it. And then at the end of the week, we meet again. Discuss the whole process, how it went with you, how it went with others. So each one of us, when they share in the group, it motivates, inspires others. And then when she has done, she got the result. When I have to do, if at all you are not able to do it. So the group energy works like, wow. Okay. And that's where, you know, I'll not call myself teacher because the whole course is very beautifully designed. I'll be there to handhold, to just pick you up when you need it. If you do not, you can go ahead by all means. But if you need it that time, I'll be there. If you're stuck in understanding, if you're stuck in doing something, not able to fit into the day-to-day life, and if you're not getting any breaks, you'll say, oh, God, I'm not getting it. I'll see to it that you are getting the result. Every step is so beautifully designed. Every 20 minutes will bring that shift, some shift in your consciousness. Okay. I would request anybody else who is there, who's ready to share. If you're attending my quest, 7-day quest, or my other things, like if you're there to share, somebody will go ahead. Just say, I unmute and say so that, I mean, I can see three hands raised. Yeah, Dimple is going ahead. Okay.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Dimple. I'm from New Bombay. I have joined almost all the courses held by Honey Didi, like whether it is online or offline courses. But initial phase, you know, like I was like, is it possible how things will go, how it will fall into place? I still remember the first day I met you, I just wanted to bring a shift in my daughter, that the kind of way she's talking to me. Yeah, if she's a child, I want some discipline in her, this, that. But then when I met you, I got to know ultimately the person I need to change and work on is only myself. And then I started, you know, coming to you, personal session pay. And there I could see the change in me and then around me. Firstly, I felt the change in me with right. Very few small activities which you taught me, self-acceptance. So initially it was very difficult. But now I can see the feeling I'm feeling in. Same thing as you told, onion peeling. Hmm. So the same word of yours, like acceptance. If in 10 sessions I'm listening, it opens up another level. The deeper level of this acceptance. Okay. What is it? Many times, like again, I'm not saying I will like, I'm upstairs. Many times I again fall down. I drain in this lockdown phase. Things are like messy sometimes. But then again, you are always there and available for me. So I always approach you and ask you for the guidance. You know, like a mother. Us bacche ko kya chahiye, as you say, the inner child. The child wanted you. Only your one word. It's okay, Dimple. But that words only uplifts me. And I always ask you for the recordings and this is whenever I listen that, it's meant for me. कोई भी रेंडम होता है या मदर्स डे पे स्पेशली आई फेल लाइक इट वॉज मेंट फॉर मी ऑन दैट डे. बाई चांस यू पोस्टेड लाइक आई एम कमिंग लाइव एट 12 एंड I was feeling like, man, how she got to know what I'm feeling now? So whether it is HYL, whether it is gratitude work, whether it is your hour of power was like turning point for in my life. So that was so, so, so interesting. So loving activities, you're working on your desire. It gives you amazing, amazing happiness. I can't explain that in words. उस टाइम पे आई एम फीलिंग लाइक अरे हाँ यार मुझे तो यहाँ पे भी अपने आप पे काम करना है मुझे यहाँ पे एंड देन एज यू टोल्ड मी लास्ट टू डेज बैक दैट आई एम डूइंग इट एज आई वांट टू डू नाउ यू डू इट फॉर योरसेल्फ बिकॉज यू लव डूइंग इट देन ओनली डू अदरवाइज प्लीज डोंट डू इट टेक अ पॉज एंड सीरियसली ऑन दैट डे आई टुक अ पॉज फॉर होल डे आई डिडंट डू एनीथिंग
नाउ यू फीलिंग देन
देन आई वाज लाइक नाउ ओके व्हिच थिंग यू वांट टू स्टार्ट ऑफ विथ. As you told me, start with only one or two work. I started very next day doing that. So, in your like 1 week courses and all, but I again say that I really want to listen to you every day. So, hour of power was a, like, aaj bhi maine usko miss karti hun. I really take that videos that I want to. But when listening to you live, as you say, is energy, that talk. So, us time pe na, I'm feeling like I have a mother. Who is telling me it's okay to make mistakes. It's okay to fall down. I always say that many times, like after understanding things, I understood completely. But on actions, maybe I'm repeating same mistake many times. Okay. Especially after the session two, some of the time. But then realizing it, and again, I'm being aware on that mistakes and I'm taking further steps.
So it's what okay. Would you say if you want to say one sentence to everybody here? Can everybody take their journey? Or is it difficult? Or like
HYL, it is like somewhere you will see the resistance like anything. Matlab, I was not at all ready to open that. Matlab, I was opening it. Nahi ra, chhod rahe, samajh nahi aa raha. It's too deep. Let it be. You make the things easier. And 1 week I heard you. I took time to digest it. Then again next week, I says, nahin, mujhse itna chhota hai, that second day I skipped or the fourth day I'm not able to do or something. Then slowly, steadily, I felt that structure is there with me. But that, you know, if you are convinced, conveying your point of view with the easiest language, with your kinder language, with your loving word, then I could really do it. And then after 5 weeks, I wanted to repeat it again and again. And this time, even I am thinking to repeat it with you. Because okay. Self-repetition is somewhere okay, right?
Correct. Okay, Dimple, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, friends, you understand this journey, though it's simple. It looks 5 weeks, sab kuch diya karna hai. It will take a lot of courage because we are not taught how to look within. I will be there and that's the important thing. And that's why I've created a 7-day quest along with it. That's a different thing altogether. Small, small techniques which we are going to do it together so that it will help you in the deepening process. Okay. And I can give you the course as it is. You can do it according to your time and convenience. But you understood when you saw when people are doing by themselves, they are resisting. But there will be some push. There will be something because our school, our education system never teaches us to go within. Get good marks, get good grades, get good gold medals, this and all. They never tell you, get inside and see what are your ugly points and be still okay with it. We are not okay with our ugly self. And in the course, we are going to be in face to face, okay? And that is the turning point of everybody's life who has taken this. So what I've decided is I've taken the 7-day quest. So last time I did 7-day heart quest. It suddenly happened with a group of 16 people. There are people over here. Now I've created the 7-day quest from victim to the empowerment with a new exercise and everything. And now I know this works well. So I'm doing kind of, you know, the work, which is kind of a case study. I'm creating a big program. And you know, those who know me, you know it well, that I've been to many, many teachers, many, many gurus and many courses, deepening processes, quite Louise AI for my language, it's a kindergarten.
I've been till the university also. Like, I've been to breakthrough courses, Amma Bhagwan's courses, Krishna Ji, Sita Ji. If you know Ekam Circles, you know what I'm talking about. Ekam Circles also, again, baby courses. We've gone through the bigger super process, conscious. We go beyond. I've done them all. In past 30 years, my journey really started from around 90 or something. That quest for searching all the why this, why that, and all those stuff. Leading to, now I know, it's actually you. It's actually here. Keep working here. So if you have to go through the journey, you can go to all the people. You have your own gurus. Please follow them. All are brilliantly well. Or if you don't have any, you can pick up any. Or you can choose to work with me because I believe in easy stuff, you know. Easily or haste khelte pyar karke kaise ho jayega, you know. The things are serious. The things are deep. They're working on your conscious level. I'm creating a course, a 30-day course, and then 6 months course, so that we are together taking best from everything and creating a new structure altogether. So it's going to be, Heal Your Life journey is beautiful journey. It needs a support by somebody who has traveled all the path. So like me, I'll be the one. So I'm combining both the courses, you know. I'm giving only for people who are present here to take both the courses together and start the journey and see the difference. Anybody else would like to go ahead with 7-day quest or something? Okay, Sairam. Okay. So Sairam will be last. And then if you want the detail, if you think you are ready, I'll come to it after Sairam. Okay, unmute please. I can't hear you. No, can't hear you.
Now?
Yeah, okay.
Yes. So the 7-day quest made me into a person. It got so many layers and layers out of which was covered. Haniji made uncover all that layers, and she made to start write down the book. I didn't have the practice to write the book. Then slowly after attended her courses, 7 days, brought out many layers which I couldn't describe in words. So, and then it was very, she does works on unconscious level where we don't know where we need to work actually, where grace is required or where some higher power is required to help you. So it was very, transforming, life transforming, I can say, and very amazing course.
Thank you. So can you share the shift in you, like before, after something, so that people connect? Okay, before iske course ke baad aise, you know, it's like helping. Yeah.
So for me, it there was a confusion, like kya karna hai, kaise karna hai, cheeze kaise aana hai career mein ya job mein. So I was a bit of confused. From kahan se shuru kare karke. So as I went and as she took us into the course, I got more and more clear about what I want, what I wanted to do, what my heart wants, and the passion for myself. And it brought out many shift breakthroughs. And right now, many great things are happening along the way. So will help a lot.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much for coming and sharing your views here. Thank you, Sairam. Okay. So now you know these courses, you know what I have gone through, what I can give it to you. So are you willing to take me as your mentor for these two courses? If yes, type yes. Are you willing to give your time? So I'm actually looking for 5 to 10 people only. I'm not looking like a big group. I don't want to work with the masses. I want to work with the people who think, yes, even they have something in them. Even they can try to change their life. They can take the support and start taking a responsibility for their life instead of just blaming around and think that even they can live the life of your dreams. So you must watch my heart talk. You will know from where I'm coming. So Louise's journey was, but I'll write my book. I'm writing already. I'm writing 3 books at a time, like, you know, different books. So when you No, when wherever you come from, you have an option to live the life of your dream. So are you willing to take that one step? Thank you. Okay, so Amit is ready to join. Okay, yes, sure, I'm in. Yes, yes, yes. So I come for this opportunity for everybody here. It's only for today, the people who are present. Otherwise, the things are different, okay? Both of them, the courses, both are world class. It has the best of teaching, best of activities. Every day will have a breakthrough for sure, okay? Or it's only for today. So one is 5-week Heal Your Life Journey and 7-day Quest, just for 6, 9, 8, 7. If you take individually, it is 6,000 for Heal Your Life Journey and 7,000 for Quest. If you tell me tomorrow, if you want to do, you need to pay 7 and 6, 13. But if you book it now, it's only 6, 9, 8, 7. Okay. And I wouldn't say you're buying a course. I have always invested most of my money, more than 30, 40 lakhs, I must say, on myself, because I feel I'm the most important asset of my life. My home, my gold, my jewelry stands too less. It's like I know if I invest in myself, I'm grooming my life every day. Okay. So this is your own investment. It is not something you're spending on. Okay. So invest now. I can share the links. Now, if you're not ready for the total amount, you were not ready for the thing, you have an option of just paying some 987 now, 987, and the remaining 6,000 by tomorrow or day after. Okay. So the links are there if you want to. You click it now so that you book for the offer. Okay. You book for the offer and then you can get the offer. If you do not do it now, you will have to buy separately, choose one or choose both. It's your choice. But if you want both of them clubbed together, okay, you have been waiting, you have been there, and I understand your commitment. You know, people have been starting, say, in uni, we were 37 and people have dropped. So understand, they were not kind of committed, they're not ready, okay? Now, if you're waiting till the end and you're ready, only thing there is required is just a token amount. And then once you put an intention, money comes in. It's not a big amount, you know it, right? You can just not even buy 1 gram of gold, I see. So it's important that you take a step now. Okay. So if you want, I'll share the link right now, 987 ka link. So you can pay through the link or you can pay through GPay or Paytm or 1 minute. Or the link which can be used as credit card, debit card, internet banking. Give me a moment. So 987 is hardly anything, you know that. And if you're taking a step, you're taking a step now, it will be non-refundable. So be very, very committed. I'm not looking at all 20, 30 people. I'm looking only for selective people who feel that, yes, if I work on myself, things around me will change. If you understood, I told you the first thing. That was the key of everything. This is the link for the whole package. If you are ready for 6, 9, 8, 7, you can pay at a time. Or if you can pay a token amount and decide on pay it later, tomorrow or day after. By Monday, you need to clear it off. Okay. The next link is for only 987. Okay. And that will give you opportunity or entry to both of the courses. And they are life transforming courses. Now, I had to stop people. There are many more people ready to share their testimonials working with me. Many more are there. And I can show you on the WhatsApp group also, on my website. There are many. And on the world website, Heal Your Life Journey, so all over the world, the courses are going on. You can check in there. So the courses are proved. You don't have to worry about the result. Every day is a result oriented. Okay. So you just check it out. So what you're getting in 6, 9, 8, 7, is Heal Your Life Journey, which is 5 weeks, but I will take 1 week extra with me, 1 hour. So I take one session, which is quite high. You know, personal sessions are quite high. But I'll be giving you that 1 hour together. And the group coaching has a very good effect on everybody. So it's worth 6,000 at a standard rate. From them, I have to give that rate. It's not my rate. And the next one is my challenge. Even if you've taken the challenge earlier, this has a different exercises. It was heart set thing. Now it is going from victim to empowerment. So first to the next level of consciousness. There are 4 levels of consciousness. We are going level by level. Only when you're second, then you can go on the third. You can't jump. You know, there's a valley ahead if you jump. You have to go step by step. So I'm going to take handhold and make you go step by step all together. That is worth 7,000. Both if you buy individually outside today's webinar will be 13,000. If you're booking it right away, it will be 6987. Okay. So just click the link and let them know what's happening. Any questions, any doubts, do let me know. And you can copy that link, keep it with yourself. And my number is there. If you feel links and all are too difficult for you, you can always use other easier platform. Can we do this by tonight? Yes, tonight you can do it. Tonight. Only till tonight. Tonight's time is 11:59. Okay. So 8452007213 is my Paytm and GPay number. Both number this. So if you're comfortable that way, you can do this deposit 987. Give the commitment to the universe. Universe, I'm ready to move forward in my life. The moment you claim this, the moment you affirm this, universe will work. I joined my course of 2 lakh rupees, okay? Without knowing, without testimonial. It was Heal Your Life Journey, not a journey course, Heal Your Life Teacher Training course. I didn't know that course exists. I just Googled, it was available. I had only 5,000 in my account. I just paid as a deposit. I said, let me see. I spoke to the teacher. Teacher said, it has been always worked. When you give signal to the universe works for you. So it's your time to give signal. And then let universe take the step. Whatever is a problem, if you're not ready for it, if money is a problem, anything is there, you can discuss with me on my WhatsApp or the call after this. And let's see what we can do. But know that it requires commitment. You just can't come and go. It's not 20 minutes of rigorous exercises, rigorous participation, attendance compulsory. If you miss out, definitely recordings will be given. But you need to do the work for it to work for you. If you do not work, it won't work for you. It's not any magic wand. It will work only when you do something at least. You have to take action. And first action is register now. Okay. So this is about that. And okay, dear. No problem. So how was today's session? And how are you taking it forward? Do let me know. And thank you. So we are just in time. I thought of 7. And so we are then on the time, and if you want the link again, if you missed out, I'm sharing again for your convenience. And if you've joined the group already, I will be joining them. Okay, let them know the link is down. The link will not be working after 11:59. Then the separate link of 6,000 and 7,000 different will be there. Okay, it's only available till midnight. And tomorrow, if you decide, it will be 13K. You will be welcome. You will be allowed. But you have to pay a little more price. 13K is also too less to bring this shift. Honestly. Okay. It's not a big amount. I can see what shift it has got to people's life. And what it can bring you money-wise, health-wise, relationship. First of all, you come closer to yourself. You come one-on-one with yourself. And that is the thing. Your gap gets closed and the things work out well. So, any other question if you have? So you let me know. And this, thank you. And thank you everybody for joining. This is today. If you go, I've told you to get the mirrors. If you got the mirrors, just say yes. Thank yourself for being here for so long. Thank yourself for thinking about joining or joining already. And this will be the best decision you can take for tomorrow. Their destiny will definitely change. It has changed everyone's destiny. Those of you who have been in this course, or this kind of course, this works, okay? This is the way that you really love yourself. You really commit to yourself, okay? You might just think of spending, I can spend on this, I can spend on this. But what about this? Always you've kept yourself last. Can you for some time keep yourself at first and start working on yourself? So if you start doing it, only then the things will work out for you. Okay. Thank you, Sangeeta. Thank you for being always here and working on you. Your commitment is commendable. Even Dimples and those guys who have been always with me, they are seeing the transformation. One, just because I'm there for them always. Second, they are also there for them. I'm teaching you to be yourself, you know, for be yourself. We are always there for others, but we are not for ourselves. So here I'm teaching you to be for yourself. Take the stand for yourself and change your life. It's like love yourself and heal your life, change your life, go to the next level. You do not know at this level of consciousness what things are you attracting. When you raise your consciousness, you don't have to do, just raise your bars. The things will fall into place. Good association, good income, good health, good knowledge will come. Go to the next level. Automatically, you know you're known by the company, okay? And how you attract your company, by the thoughts you have in your head, the way you believe about yourself, those kind of people will be there in your life, right? So, okay. So there are a few questions. Please tell about the limitless field free to join that I'll put up in the group. Thanks for a wonderful session. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much. See you. Hope to see you in the courses together. Namaste. Thank you. Can you forward the link of your life-changing experience? Okay. Yeah. My heart talk, right? Yeah, I will do it. There was somewhere. So you're there in the group, WhatsApp group, and share for everybody there. Is it okay? Or am I getting it here? Heart talk. Okay. I don't know. Can you send it to all? Oh, I cannot send it. Okay.
Students are also there with me.
Ha,
it's
started.
I was just working at the
moment. Okay, so this is my heart talk. Okay, so you can see it, watch it, and you know where I'm coming from. And it's not only Sam Louise in America. Anybody who takes action will see the shift. And we've seen people getting the results already. Don't delay it. You'll never get such opportunities, honestly. And then maybe you're ready for the next level and pay lakhs of rupees and do it by all means. But at this level, getting all the knowledge, all the experience in this simple format, you know, there's a bite-sized thing, but they are working on your unconscious. You don't even realize how are they shifting your consciousness, you know. So just join in, jump in. Again, only for few people. If you're ready, do come, okay? Sure. So the... Okay, no problem. So, you know, cost of not joining is living the old mediocre life you're living. Cost of joining is bring the shift in your life now. Choice is yours. Choice is always yours. Okay. Choose what you want and then let's take a decision. So, I'll say goodbye. Thank you once again for taking decision to joining in. It's a good gift you gave for your 90 minutes, also maybe 2 hours now. Thank you all. Love you all. See you on the other side. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.